Hello everybody and welcome to my channel. This is Martina and after a short creative break I'm back with the completed two journals which I showed you in my last video. Well, this is the bigger one, Lavender Love in big, and this is her little sister, Lavender Love in small. I'm afraid this video will be a little bit longer than usual because there is a lot to tell, and without further ado, I'm just going for it. So, this is Lavender Love, the big one, the bigger one. Well, the cover has been created by some pretty cardstock, which I have secured by several layers of varnish so that it's really resistible. And it has been decorated with doilies, with this really, really pretty purple doily, which I recently bought. And behind it or beneath it, there is another doily, you can probably see it, which stems from an old tablecloth, which I had been gifted. I also have been gifted this wonderful, pretty butterfly. It comes from my friend May. Hi, May. And actually, this was the inspiration for me to start this journal making. It's so pretty, and I have further decorated it with some fluffy things here. It's sewn on. Also, the purple roses as further decoration are sewn on, and it's also further decorated with several layers of lace, and also a really, really pretty, stunning trim. Some fabric coming from an old apron, and also on the back side I have added two layers of lace in purple and in white. Well, there is a lot of purple and lavender, so many, many different shades of lavender will be found in this journal. The measurements, well, it has 20 centimeters, 12.5 centimeters and a 5.5 centimeter spine, and in inches, 8 times 5 times 2 1/4. Well, and this is already the problem, because as usual, I have filled it up. I have filled it up to the max, I would say, and therefore it's again a lady crocodile. I'm going to show you. So, but let's first have a look on the way it has been closed. So I have used two different sari silk ribbons, one in purple or in a dark purple and one in a dark green, because there will be also a lot of green, white and of course purple in this journal. And once I open it like this, you see what happens. Well, it really flips out. So it's really a big one, a chunky monkey one, but I hope you don't mind. And because I know that it's sometimes difficult to stay until the end of a especially long video, I am going to show you something on the back first before I start to do the journey of this journal from the beginning, because I think also the backside deserves some views. So let's see. This is the last pages, and here I have added some fabric pocket. So I have put it into some ruffles. I've added a trim, a really, really pretty trim, and inside. Look, also have a look on this really, really pretty cardstock. On the inside, I have a huge journaling card, which I have sewn with this fancy stitching. And also something which I have collaged. So it's a tag which I have collaged. I have used some of the paper and the material I have used throughout this journal. And of course, this is also some really pretty design paper or digital paper. So now let's go back to the beginning. And what I really like is that you have this wonderful look on this trim or border or whatever you call it. It has been gifted to me by my friend Maria, and it's so pretty. And now you have the first look, or not the first look, but you have to look on the first pages. And it starts with a kind of a flippy out. And this is a pocket, obviously. And in this pocket, there is a journaling card, which is also very nice, and also very nice from the backside. And I have further decorated it with some lace. And you are going to see this lace also in this journal, because it's really, really pretty. And then have a look on this wonderful oriental trim. Behind it there is another huge journaling card, which I have further decorated with this light tulle purple ruffle. I love this color. It's so bright and impressive. And on the back side I have used some coffee dyed paper. So the journal has more than 160 pages back and front, and I have not counted smaller pages or flip outs or whatsoever. So it's really, as I say, and you see it, it's a chunky monkey. It has 5 signatures, and we start with the first one. You see it has been decorated with double trims, so this really nice white trim and another purple trim. And the inside of this first signature has been decorated with this really, really pretty digital design from Bontic Vintage Designs. And here I have added a little pocket, and this is this card this book belongs to, because it might belong to you. This one is available in my Etsy shop, like the smaller one. So here I have really pretty vellum. I couldn't help it. I had to use these old flower pictures, which are these collector's items and which are about 80 years old, and they are so pretty. And of course there are many, many of them are in purple, so I have used some of them in here. And also I have turned this into a pocket, and behind it you find one of my self-created tags, and it has been done. But then I thought, well, it's purple, and I added a little bit more purple acrylic paint on it so that it really gets a purple look. And from the back side, it's also pretty. So here I have made another collage on a tag, and I have added different fabrics and different elements sewn together. This lace. When I bought it, I thought, oh my God, because I bought it online, and I thought, oh my God, I'm never going to use it because it's really, really green. But look how perfect it is in combination with this wonderful design paper. So it's the perfect match, I would say. And I have added this journaling card in this pocket. There are many of these journaling cards featuring some scenes in purple, different kind of scenes in purple, and I because it's a purple theme, I wanted to have them all in, and there are many of those. You, who probably will be the future owner, of course, can do whatever you want with this journal, and you can make it your own, because there is purple, but most of the purple also stems from these cards and journaling cards and so on. So you can turn it maybe into another scheme if you want, but maybe you leave it. So this is some nice trim over here. And as usual, I have also left some of the pages a little bit more empty, so that it can also be used for writing. Here I have another journaling card with some romantic design, sitting in a romantic pocket, which I have decorated with some folded trim. This is my self-dyed, hand-dyed paper with some gold and some color speckles and coffee dyed. Here, this is another small thing, and behind it there is this little journaling card, and I have attached it with a trim which was in my stash and which perfectly matches this purple theme. So this is another journaling card sitting on some nice cardstock or design paper. Also decorated with trim, a lot of trim, a lot of lace, ruffles, in different material. You will find almost everything you would like to see in a journal, I guess. And this is coffee dyed paper, which I made. This is some coloring, which I tried with a light purple here on the edge, and also a purple trim. This butterfly, which I sometimes turn into a pocket, carrying some purple small journaling card. Nice paper, belly band, and of course of course, because I think we all need a little bit of magic in our lives. I have added a fairy, and maybe there are some more fairies. I think there's also an angel in this journal, so there is magic. And this is some nice trim. And here we come to the next pocket. So yeah, there are many, many pockets in there, and many journaling cards, many tags, all backed with other material, other paper, and you can use it for writing. Now we come to the center spot of the first signature, and this stems from a household catalogue of Victorian household items. And this is not an old one, but I coffee dyed it in order to give it this old look, but it's a copy of an original one. And it looks very pretty, I guess. And I also love these old clocks, and also here, it's really nice. Another pocket, and look at this. I couldn't help it. I had to make this little bow with this thing in the middle. Two journaling cards inside. So, you see, this is coffee dyed paper. This is this pretty paper. This is this paper where I use some purple dye. And this is another one of my collector's items, flower pictures, which I love so much. And here I've made a little flower myself, and I added a rhinestone. This, this lace I have dyed because it was white, obviously, and I wanted to give it this purple look, this light purple or lavender look, so it's nice, and I ruffled it. And here there is another nice picture of lavender, violet, pink, not pink, purple, stitched with fancy stitching. This is, again, the hand-dyed paper. I think it's so pretty what came out, and I made some little bit of stamping here. Then I couldn't help it, another playful thing. I just glued together two circles with some purple motifs. I put a very nice bookmark into this side pocket. And then you see the decoration with these ruffles, but it's more than just decoration because this is a pocket. And this decoration has been put on a journaling card, which shows some lavender. And this is tulle. And this is so pretty. I have not a lot of this color, but I used it throughout this journal a bit. This is stamping on old book paper. This is this pretty vellum. This is a collage, which I made from different material, lace and some digital paper. And we are at the end of the first signature, and we come straight into the second one. And the second one starts with something special, I think, because this was also the last thing I did on this journal. So first of all, you see I have added some lace, which is also hand dyed. And when you turn it, then you see this picture of lavender in a window, but you also see a bow. And when you open this bow, you see that it can be flipped up, flip out, and it's decorated with some nice lace design paper. And behind this belly band, I have added a collage, which I made, or a picture, but composition, which I made using my dried flowers from the garden. And I don't do that often, so I don't have a lot of dried flowers. So I think these probably were almost the last ones. I have secured it with this fabric. And on the back side, I have written down what it is. So the first two are borage, and this is forget-me-not, and this is blueberry. And this was the last thing I did on this journal because I had the idea and I thought, well, I have to do it. So this is gift wrapping paper, believe it or not. Just some paper in purple, some purple lace. And when you turn it, then you see a wonderful picture of a Victorian rose. It's not in purple. It's more a dark, dusty pink. But it's very well matches the color scheme of this silk ruffle, which I have made here from a vintage sari. And here I have added some, and I have to cut this because it's sewn on, I have added some really old lace. And you can flip it up and use it for writing, use it to hide something. And here I've added a fabric tape, which shows some lavender and other purple flowers. Coffee dyed paper doily. On the back side of this ruffle decorated page, you see this and you can enlarge it. And what you see here, of course, because those of you who know me know that I almost every time do have a peacock in my journals. And this is this one. And I love the colors. I love the colors so well in harmony with this vintage sari ruffle. This is craft paper, which has been printed, not by me, bought it like that. Vellum paper again, some marble paper. And now we come to the center spot of the second signature. And again, this is such a pretty picture with these flowers here. I love it. And because there's something behind it, and I wanted to show it to you, and I also wanted to show this to you, but typically it stays together. I have secured it with this pin or with the clip. And you see there is a belly band decorated with a flower, and there are journaling card on this side, and I put it back later, and a journaling card on the other side, and here I did some stenciling. And this is another trim which I have used in also in very nice purple tones, sitting on this purple design paper. So this is some stamping, and this is hand dyed silk. Now we come to a different color scheme. You know, some of you who know some of my journals do know that I love to change the color scheme when turning a page from time to time. So what I did here is I'm more in this green, pink, peachy color scheme. I have made a pocket. I have decorated it with a ruffle from double lace. Decorated it further, and inside there are several journaling cards and another fairy, as I had promised. And on the opposite side, this is hand dyed paper, and I made a stamp, a light stamp on it. This is a collage I made, so it's lace and silk and design paper put together and sitting in this side pocket. This is one of my hand-created tags, which I have added here. And you can turn it off if you don't like it like this. Well, you will, because you can remove the washi tape. And this is the purple page, which you can see here. This is this paper, this is that paper. And you see also the gift wrapping paper has some purple in it. Really nice. And in this side pocket I have added just one page of a Japanese book, which I recently bought. I don't know what it says, but I think it's I like the writing, so therefore I kept it here. So now we come to the third signature, which has been decorated by two layers of lace, respectively ruffle and lace. And I have also stitched on another digital paper on this design paper, and when you turn it, then you see, oh, there is a flip up showing some I don't know what is the name in English. I have to say, I know that it's Glycinien in German, or Blauregen, but I don't know in English. Can flip it up. There you have another, oops, I'm off camera. There you have another decoration. And you have something hidden, and this is another of the tags which I did, and I have further made it purple. This is coffee dyed paper, stamped. This is some special paper with this, it's Indian paper with this little ornaments over here. decorate it further. This is a paper bag, and in this paper bag there is a journaling card. There's another of my hand-dyed paper, and this is of course stamped. And here this is a pocket in this butterfly pocket, and there is another tag. Some pretty paper here, some lace over there. This is a collage which I made, and I have also secured it here, but this one I think you cannot remove because I had further put on glue when putting on the washi tape. So this is relatively fixed, but I think I like it quite a lot. Purple. And this is the center spot of the, this is the center spot of the third signature. So this is the middle of the middle. And I've used this really, really stunningly pretty lace, turned it into four pockets, and there is something inside, of course. So I'm going to show you. This is another one of this old flower pictures and some others. Side pocket, butterfly, again this really pretty lace which I have put on this design paper, and here you see another purple journaling card. Hand-dyed paper, nicer from this side. This is this paper bag, decorated further, and inside there is another of my beloved peacocks. And this paper bag I have also coffee dyed and stenciled, as you can see. And this is a side pocket, and this side pocket is empty, so you can put in whatever you wish. So now we are at number four, and number four starts with wrapping around this signature, and this one has been created from wallpaper where I've made a little collage with burlap and lace and trim, and also decorated from the inside so that it's in harmony all together. Then this signature starts with decoration of two layers of lace stitched around. This is a bigger collage which I made, a tag, where I've used several or different material. I also sprayed it with some color, and I have put it in here. Lace, another pocket, another journaling card. I love this. I love the combination of this. It's a different style. It's a different design, but I think it's very harmonic. This you can flip up. Hand-dyed lace. This is, probably you know if you have seen some of my other videos, this is the wonderful coffee-dyed, coffee-stenciled paper from May. This is my own design. This is just for decoration purposes, decorated with some lace. And here you have two journaling cards sitting in this nice pocket. And here I have also made some decoration with this trim, which has these, which has these nice fringes. Stamping, darker vellum, coffee dyed paper, craft paper. Again, decorated like it's a pocket, and this the inside has been decorated with tulle, so you have this nice view on it. And I think the colors are so well together. This craft color and this purple are so pretty. And when you open it, then you have another stunning view, I guess, on a green and purple scenery with different egg-shaped design elements. And here you have two further pockets, and inside these pockets there are two cards showing Victorian roses. I couldn't help it. I have to use these Victorian pictures, and also the craft paper from this side looks so pretty. Here there is a side pocket, and in the side pocket there are two journaling cards, or let's say a bookmark and a journaling card. So now we have an empty page, we have something stamped, we have this coffee dyed paper from May, we have a side pocket, and there is a little postcard in there, decorated here, some decoration there, and this is another pocket, and there are two journaling cards in this wonderful purple tones. Also, this pocket has been decorated with two layers of lace. There is lace on the edge. I couldn't help it. I think I will not learn. So, this is the end. And you see, this is the wallpaper. And here I've added another of these pretty flower pictures. Yeah, now we are already at number 5. We are almost done with the first one. So, this is again satin ruffle. Look at this pretty, pretty design paper which I have used to decorate the inside. Really, really pretty. Here I have also some, I found in my stash this tull, and this comes in so different colors, and it's so perfect with this one, and it's also so nice with the backside. And here I've used some Indian trim, and I made another collage, and I have further decorated this collage with this, circles. I was into circles today. Yes, when I did it, not today. Coffee dyed paper, coffee dyed stenciled paper, another pretty pocket where I have made this ruffling decoration, two journaling cards, or let's say a bookmark and a journaling card, some nice lace. Again, this purple colored page, hand-dyed paper, pretty paper, empty paper. Now we come to the angel card, and the angel card has been attached using a clip which I have created from different material, and it looks like this. It also is further decorated. It has some tulle over here, and it has been attached with this clip in order to decorate it further and to keep it in place. This is old lace on hand-dyed paper. This is some decoration coming from this scrap paper, which I cut out and added here in the center spot. This is coffee-dyed paper. Here we have again this decorated pocket. Two bookmark-type journaling cards, let's say. And this is a little book which I have created from this one. So it's just for further notes or whatever. And it looks nice, I guess. Washi tape, some stamping. This is another side pocket and another journaling card. So, a ballet dancer. Nice decorative paper on the inside. This you have seen already. I show it to you again because I love it. And this was Lavender Love, the bigger one. If you still have energy, you may want to stay tuned for the smaller one, because it's also, I think, quite nice. But have another look on this here. So that's her. She's available in my Etsy shop, and I hope she gets a new home. And I'm sure she will. So that's the smaller one. And those of you who have seen my previous video, where I have talked a little bit about the making of and the thinking process, might remember that I said this one will also have a butterfly on the front, on the cover, this one. And yesterday, sometimes things happen, yesterday something popped out of my stash. I don't know how this happened. Sometimes things just appear, I think. And what appeared were some paper flowers. And I thought, this could also be a nice decoration, maybe like this or that. And I couldn't decide. I didn't know. So I left it off, as you can see, and I will leave it up to the future owner of this journal to decide and to let me know if she wants it like this or like that or just like this or naked at all. I don't know. So it's up to the new owner. So, but have a look. She is also nicely decorated with several layers of lace, trim. I have decorated the spine further with this thing which I made and added this purple rose here. And on the backside it looks like this. And also there is a little lace over there. So again, it's also secured with varnish because it's design paper and I don't want to damage it. So it's been closed with this trim in purple and white, and I think it's so pretty and it's perfect to this one here because it has exactly the colors. So let's open it. Again, also this one, also the little sister is Chunky Monkey. You see it. But let's start. The dimensions first. So 13.5 centimeter, 11 centimeter, 5 centimeter. Inches, 5 1/4 times 4 1/4 times 2. And 120 pages, or more than 120 pages, because as I say, I always count only the bigger ones. So it starts with a flip out composition, and you remember probably this angel from the bigger one, so I couldn't help it because I think it's so cute, and maybe it's a Cupido, and it's always good to have something magic in our lives, I think. So this one is also decorated with some bow here, and it's a pocket obviously, and there is a journaling card inside. You can flip it up. You see there is some decoration. And this is a die cut. And I have used some fabric which came in the design of this leaf. So it looks as if this is a flower leaf. As if it's put all together, but it's two different things. Oops. And so you can further flip it up like this. There is something behind. Nicely decorated, also decorated here, and you can also turn this out, take this out, and then you have this nice belly band, and behind it, of course, a peacock. You would have missed it, right? If it wasn't there. So, 3 signatures, 120 pages, and this one is also decorated with this pretty fringy border. And here again, one of those really pretty flower pictures, and turned into a pocket, decorated with some lace over here and some lace over there, and there is something cute behind it. So this little journals, they are not so easy to make, I have to say, because you have really to make things small, and it's exactly the same amount of work, I would say. But they are so cute. So I really love from time to time to make these little journals because, as I say, a handful of joy. So when you turn it, then you have a side pocket, and behind it there are two, yeah, of course, mini journaling cards. And as usual, I have used design papers and digital papers from different several artists. And again, this pretty vellum paper, hand-dyed paper, coffee stencil paper decorated with some old fabric. Here's some decoration. There's a pocket, and inside this pocket there's a journaling card sitting on some really nice design paper decorated with some purple lace. When you turn it, there's a circle which forms a pocket, and behind it there are three different tags all matching nicely in different shades of purple and some green. And again, some decoration over here. This is also a paper bag, and in this paper bag I have put I've put some die cut in a rose motif, because I have also stamped a rose on it. Here's some lace sewn on the belly dancer, which you have seen before. This is hand dyed paper, a belly band using the Indian trim, which I love so much. And behind it there are two journaling cards, or a bookmark and a journaling card, satin ruffles in this really, really bright pink, bright purple. I love this color. This is again from this sari trim, and I love it because it nicely matches to this green over here and to this purple over there. And on the opposite side, I have added, I have added this little tag, and this little tag has also a pocket, and in this pocket there are two, not real ones, but two pretend to be stamps. This is the center spot, and the center spot has this decorative page, and this has been turned into two pockets, and inside there are two mini journaling cards. This is a crown with a little bit of purple, and this is something secret. Who knows what's inside? Hand-dyed paper. Here I have turned this cotton lace into a pocket and further decorated it with some trim. And behind it, on top of some nice design paper, and behind it there is a journaling card, which has been backed with coffee-dyed paper. Stamping. Coffee-dyed paper. This is another side pocket with two journaling cards. So cute. Couldn't help it. Paper bag. And in this paper bag, which I have coffee dyed and color dyed and stamped, as you can see, and in this paper bag I have put on in this came from, I think, from a journal or so, from a handwriting journal, and I just made some embossing, and I love the purple, and it's exactly the perfect purple for this journal, so therefore it's sitting here. Well, let's say it's sitting like that. Now we are more in a more greenish color scheme, and this is a belly band decorated with a daffodil, and behind it there is some more information about some flowers, and so this nicely fits together, and it sits here. This is this trim which you have seen from before, from the lace, which I've used to decorate the edge. So this I have glued most of the laces, and as the decoration of the edges I have sewn on, but some I have glued, because this is the ideas which I get once the journal is almost finished. And here I have added several longer decorative elements, like another fairy and this really pretty purple violets or so. Some stamping, coffee-dyed paper, hand-dyed paper, vellum. This is this flippy out, which I did for this small journal. And here there is this tiny, tiny tag, which I have decorated with a little bit of tulle. And it sits here to look pretty. But you can also use it for writing, of course. So, this is the end of the first signature. And now we come to number two. Decorated with the lace, which I have hand-dyed. Here we have another die cut, which is hydrangea and rose, and of course perfect colors, and a little folded envelope, and inside this envelope there are two tiny journaling cards, which I have sewn around, of course. Also here I have made this this wobbly thing with the circles. And I have also attached something on the back side. But before I show you, this is the paper clip which I have created from different laces and material. And it's used to, first of all, cover this clip. And second, to also hold this journaling card or bookmark or however you want to call it in place. And it looks nice, I think. And this here is decoration, of course. It nicely matches in terms of colors to this bookmark and to this paper on this the opposite side, which has also been decorated with lace. Guess what? Coffee dyed and stenciled. This is some wallpaper, which I used because of the color. Nothing special. And this is the hand-dyed silk, which I used. This is fabric tape, which shows some purple flowers. This pocket here I have created by collaging different laces, scraps of laces together. So there is more thread than lace, I would say. But it looks nice, I think, and it matches perfectly to this design paper. And there is some marble paper. And there is also another journaling card or tag. Stamp, special paper. Look at this. I like this view. This is a die cut behind, but it looks so nice. And here I have turned this into a pocket. And in this pocket there are two, because it's a small journal, there are two tiny tags or journaling cards. This is this gift wrapping paper, which you have seen in the other journal. Stamping, two journaling cards over here, lace, center spot, and center spot has also been created to form two pockets, and in these two pockets there are two journaling cards. And here there is some washi tape on top. Yeah, so there is something behind this. What can this be? Well, let's flip up, and you see this is the picture of a lady. And she wears some purple flowers in her hair, and I have put her in a frame which I have created myself by collaging and decoupaging and flaking and varnishing and whatsoever. So this is behind this pretty trim. This is stamped on book paper. This is just a flower which I have created, and once I had glued it on, I realized that because it's really thin paper, that it might be in danger. So what I did is I have, afterwards I had glued on this, and then I tried to cut it in shape, which was not that easy. Stamping. Here, this is another journaling card or tag, which I have glued on. It also has a little pocket from my decoupage exercises, and behind it there are two pretend to be stamps, which look nice, I guess. Rather like this, I guess. So this is glued on. This is a pocket formed from vellum, and inside there is a journaling card. This is a double pocket, several circles. So some lace over here. Guess what? Peacock over there. This is the craft paper which I've used to decorate the edge. And we are at the last and third signature. And this one I have created by attaching this wheel on top of this design paper, and it forms a pocket. And here there is a nice bookmark or journaling card and some decorative element. Decorated with lace. The inside is also very nice. This is hand-dyed silk. And this is a nice journaling card, which is kept in place by this paper clip, which I have decorated with a button. This is again vellum. And what I like is, because this is writing, and when you look through it, you see that behind it there is a postcard. And this postcard is not in purple, but in blue. But nevertheless, I think it nicely matches here. And in order to keep it visible, I have attached it with this fabric. I hope it stays. This is Japanese paper in this really pretty pink and yellow colors. Hand-dyed paper, old lace, self-created tag, sitting in this belly band, stamping, and this one here you can flip, but you can also tear, seize, take out, and this is a butterfly, which I have created, or which I have decorated with this tull. It's not the same color, but I think it still looks very nice, and it's very pretty when it sits in this pocket. And here there is a side pocket, and you can take this off. This is a journaling card sitting on this nice design paper, which is decorated with lace. This is also from my friend May. And this is the center spot. And the center spot I have further decorated with this pretty paper. I love it. It's so nice. It's such a nice picture. So I glued it on afterwards. Therefore, I've used washi tape, as you can see. And then here, this is this lace, which you have seen before. You can flip it up. And then there is something glued on, and this is a tag, which also has another tag. And then you see here, this is a dried flower, which I have glued on, so it's secure. And here I've added a bead, and this is a pocket and a journaling card, a rhinestone. Another pocket, I think almost the last pocket, stamping. Japanese paper, stenciled paper, vellum, coffee-dyed paper, last page, pockets. So this is a pocket, and in this pocket there are three different tags, journaling cards, you name it, sitting here. So this is Lavender Love, the smaller one, the little sister. Little sister, big sister. I hope you like it. I know it was long. Sorry for that, but it also took me quite a while to make it. So I thought maybe it's better. Or let me know. Do you like it this way, or would you rather like to have two videos? Would be interesting to know. Thank you very much for watching. Thank you very much, especially if you stayed until the very end. And thanks to all of you. I hope to see you soon. And this is Martina. Bye-bye.